Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Beaudry Field on the campus of Dracut High School. As the Dracut High School Middies welcome the Westford Academy Grey Ghosts. And now we are, will be the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and remove your caps and join us for a moment of silence in memory of all those who lost their lives on September 11th, 2001. Followed by the playing of our national anthem by the Dracut High School Marching Band.
That was the playing of your national anthem by the Dracut High School Marching Band with a wonderful job. Dracut has lost the toss and will be kicking off. They will be going from right to left on your TV screen. Dracut is coming off a disappointing season from last year, and they are determined to have a good year this year, and they've worked hard since August, so it should be an interesting ball game. Now, both teams will run a spread offense, and both teams will play a similar 40 defense, so it'd be like a mirror image sometimes, if you might see from the offensive and defensively. So we'll just see who plays better, and we'll come out on top. Dracut is, of course, in the blue jerseys, with white striping, silver helmets, while the Westford Grey Ghosts are in their gray pants, home road white shirts, and gray helmets. Kicking off for Dracut is number two, Justin Gauthier. Deep for Westford Academy is number 11, Nicholas Ferrello, and number 24, Eric Jacobson. And the season is underway. Ball is kicked short, fielded by number seven, Kevin Enos. Enos brings the ball up to the 41-yard line where Westford will put the ball in scrim and play. First and 10 for the Westford Grey Ghosts. Out comes the Westford offense. With number 10, Connor Delahart at quarterback. Ball is snapped, handed to number 31, Ben Cassidy. Cassidy cuts it up and has a first down with a 12-yard gain up to the Dracut 45-yard line. Again, Westford goes in no huddle, calling the plays at the line of scrimmage. Dellenhart gets the snap, rolls to his left, fires out to his right, complete. To number 81, Scotty Callahan. 9-yard gain down to the Dracut 37-yard line. Again, no huddle for Westford. Snap, give is to number 31. Ben Cassidy for the first down. First and 10, Westford at the Dracut 35-yard line. Again, no huddle, trips right. Dellenhart calling signals in shotgun, maybe more of a pistol. Takes a snap, hands the ball off to number 31. Ben Cassidy. Cassidy gets the ball down to the 29-yard line with a gain of 6 yards, so it'll be second and 4. As Westford is sustaining a drive on their first possession. Dellenhart, again waiting snap. Number 11 comes in motion, Nicholas Ferrello. Snap, give to Ferrello off the left side. And it looks like he gets the first down to the 29-yard line of Dracut. Excuse me, down to the 24-yard line. Again, Westford, no huddle, calling the play at the line of scrimmage. Dellenhart in shotgun. Snap the corner, looking to his right, fires to his right, complete to number 81. Scotty Callahan, who is taken down by a swarm of Dracut tacklers, led by number one, Zach Burgoyne. Westford back to the line of scrimmage. Connor takes the snap, hands the ball, keeps the ball on his own read. Fumble, ball's on the ground. It looks like Dracut has recovered. Recovered by number 18, Stephen Lopez. Big break for Dracut. And they started to stiffen up on that drive by Westford, and they recovered the ball at their own 16-yard line. First and 10. Quarterbacking for Dracut is Thomas Crowley. And as you see, Dracut will come out in a no huddle, very similar to Westford's offense. Crowley's in shotgun. We're going to his right. Snap. Handoff.
Flag
on the play. Looks like a legal procedure on Dracut. They blew the play dead. So now we have a first down and 15 yards to go from Dracut's own 10-yard line. Again, Crowley leads him up to scrimmage. Trips right. Snap to Crowley. Handoff. Inside handoff. Doesn't go far.
So
a second down and 15. That carry. I'm trying to make the numbers out, ladies and gentlemen. It's by number 31, David Choate. So we have a second and 15. With Dracut on their own 10-yard line. Crowley brings them out. Again, we have a balance. We got split receivers each side. Crowley back to pass, plenty of protection down the middle, incomplete. Intended for number 6, Michael O'Donnell. So now we have a 3rd and 15 from Dracut from their own 10-yard line. Dracut just may run the ball here. This is you don't want to be throwing a pick or turning the ball over. So we'll see what the coaches decide. Again, Crowley's in shotgun. Call signals, snap, back to pass. Looks downfield. Now he's flushed out of the pocket. Heads over to his left, fires, incomplete. Intended for number one, Zach Burgoyne. Now it's 4th down and 15 for Dracut in a obvious punting situation. Dracut will be punting out of its own end zone. Snap, punts away. Fair catch by number 24. And he catches that ball. That's a nice play. He catches the ball. Eric Jacobson made a nice play catching that ball with a fair catch. And now Westford has the ball on Drake's 34-yard line. Currently, ladies and gentlemen, the clock is not operating, so we can't tell you how much time is left in the quarter, but they've had two possessions, so I'm thinking that maybe 4 to 5 minutes has run off the clock, but the time is being kept down on the field. Connor Duggenhart, snap, handoff inside to number 31. Ben Cassidy. Cassidy goes up to the 25-yard line for a gain of 9 yards. Again, Dillinghut in shock and pistol now. Hand off to Cassidy. Cassidy brings it down for the first down down on the 20-yard line. Tackle by
number 53, Richie Glenn. Enough for a Westford Academy first down.
And first round for Westford. Degenhart again behind center in shotgun. Cassidy to his right, trips left. He's back to pass, he goes out to his left, fires, complete to number 11. Nicholas Ferrello. Second down and two at the Dracut 12. Degenhart in pistol formation. Quick toss out to the right. Complete. Number 24. Eric Jacobson. It looks like there's a flag. We could have a holding on Westford, as it appears. Drake dodges a bullet here, so he'll take advantage of it. So it was a spot foul, and it brings. So now we'll have a second down. Actually, it's a second down and 5 to go.
Second and 6 for Westford Academy.
A little confusion on the Westford Academy. Trips left. Degenhart behind center. Cassidy to his left. Back to pass. Fires out to the right. Complete. First down.
Pass complete. The left side, enough for a Westford Academy first down. First and goal inside the 10.
Drake a tackle by number 8, Troy Zacher. First and goal for Westford inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. Dillinghart gives the...
Hand off, taken down on the backfield.
Gives the Cassidy taken down for a loss of about a yard, so it'll be second down and about 9. Second down and goal from the 9. Degenhart behind center and pistol. Cassidy offset to his left, trips left also. Gonna takes the snap, hands the ball off to Cassidy. Cassidy fights down to about the 6-yard line. Tackled by Justin Gauthier. Nice play by Gauthier. So now we have a third and goal from the 6. So far, we'll see with Drake had to go out of turnover in this end of the field. Westford Academy's lost series. Degenhardt over center, actually in shotgun. Cassie to his left, rolls left. Fires in the end zone. And touchdown. Nice play by Westford Academy. Number 16, Kyle Pelocci. Kick is spotted, kick is up, and the kick is good. And in the first quarter, Westford breaks the ice and leads Drake at 7-0. Folks, this is you can see the value of field position. Even though Westford turned the ball over, they pinned Drake in deep. And Drake had a punt, and they started this drive from their own 35-yard line. Short fields like that lead to touchdowns. Just got a word from the official in the field. There appears to be 4 minutes left in the first quarter. Hank, how you doing? In the booth now is a former Dracut High School baseball coach, Hank Golick. That's who I was saying hello to. My old coach years ago, that makes him feel really old. Told me I couldn't pitch, and he was right. Kickoff down on the Dracut 5. Good return. I'll get that number for you. Returned by number 31. David Choate. Drake at first and 10 from their own 25-yard line.
Drake will take over first and 10 from their own 25.
Drake comes out on offense, no huddle. I don't think either of these teams will huddle up all night. So Thomas Crowley brings him out, hands the ball off inside, and swarmed by a gaggle of Westford High defenders. So Dragon has a second, and they lost a little on that play, second and 11. Crowley out. Crowley in shotgun. Dual receivers, white, right. One receiver split left. Zach Burgoyne in the backfield. Crowley calling signals. Snap. Handoff inside. Again, swarmed by just about the entire Westford High defense, Westford Academy defense. I think 9 of them were in on that tackle.
It'll be third and long for the Middies.
No gain in the play. Third and 10.5, third and 11.
We have an official timeout on the field.
Timeout, Drake it.
Timeout, Drake it. And then to do it back to 11.
Dracut needs to stay on the field a little bit and get a first down here and start building some first downs, getting some offensive momentum. Give their defense a break. The defense has been out in the field for two long series by Westford, and that only goes to drag you, actually tire you out by the end of the night. So let's see what Coach Rivers has up his sleeve. And the Dracut High coaching staff, head coach Jason Rivers, assistant coaches Shane O'Donnell, Joe Ganji, Phil Peters, Phil Bolduck, and Mike Druin. For the Westford Academy, Gray Ghost, head coach Adam Gagne, assistants Brian Rourke, Patrick Gendron, Mike Parent, from Dracut, I might add, Jeff Molesso, Bruce Rich, and Jeff Bunyan. I believe Mike Parent still lives in Dracut. He's coaching Westford Academy. Yes, he does. Dracut comes out with an all-important 3rd and 10. Crowley under center. Trips to his left. Single receiver out to his right. Pass is complete. Number six, Michael O'Donna. Gain of roughly 8 yards, so we'll have a 4th and 2. Is it too early for decision time here? I guess it's not. Looks like Drake is going for it in the 4th and 2. Dual receivers right and left. Crowley in shotgun. Calling signals. Snap to Crowley. Scrambles out to his left. He's going to keep it, and he goes out of bounds. Let's see the spot of the official. It looks like he was 1 yard short. Westford Academy will take over the ball at their 34-yard line. This is where they started last drive, at their 34. Deglenhardt under center, but he's in shotgun. Trips to his left. Snap, looking to his right. Fires down the field, wide open. Is number 7, Kevin Enos, for the touchdown.
That's by Deglenhardt. Completing the left side for a 34-yard touchdown.
Very well-conceived play by the Westford Academy Gray Ghosts. And executed it to perfection for a touchdown. And Westford is lining up for the extra point. Number 16, Kyle Pilotsky. I'm sorry, Kyle, is lining up for the PAT, being held by Andrew Cathcart. Snap, ball down, kick is up. And the kick is good. So we're probably coming to the end of the first quarter here with the score. Westford Academy 14, Dracut nothing. Long way to go on this one, folks. Dracut needs to sustain a drive on offense. Yeah, there he is on your screen. That was Mike Parent, assistant coach at Westford Academy. Used to be the head coach there. I believe former principal. And this is his style of offense. Back deep for Dracut, receiving the kick will be number 31. I'll get to it, folks. David Choate. Kick down to the Dracut 5-yard line, almost to the goal line. Choate brings it out, sees a hole, cuts upfield. Nice return out to the 32-yard line. One step from breaking that.
Kick got cracked by number 31, David Schoen. All the way out to the 32.
Let's see what Drake can do from an offense. There's a long way to go here. Choten shotgun, call in signals. Snap. For two, give a 2 yard gain to number, I believe 21, Danny O'Connell. Second and 7.5, second and 8 for Dracut. Crowley behind center, takes the snap, hands the ball. Nice gain to the 41-yard line for 3rd and 1 by number
two, Justin Gauthier.
By number two, Dustin Gauthier. Justin Gauthier.
Close to a first down, but just shy. It will be 3rd and 1 for the Middies.
Nice gain up to the 41. It'd be a 3rd and 1. I think Dracut is a 2-down situation here because they're almost at midfield. And I'm sure the 2 plays and the coaches are thinking of another play should this one not be successful for the first down. Gauthier again. Looks like I'm looking at the official coming in with the spot. Looks like it's enough for the first down. Excuse me. So we'll see. Maybe they'll call for a measurement. No, first down. Dracut gets their first down of the game. Maybe now can sustain some offensive momentum and give their defense a rest. And that's the end of the first quarter. With Westford Academy 14 and Dracut nothing. Now the officials will spot the ball. Dracut, that was an important first down. The defense was on the field for 3 long drives, or 3 long time-consuming drives, and this is good ample rest to put some energy in the batteries a little bit and get moving here. So Dracut will have the ball at their own 43 with a 1st and 10, starting the second quarter. Here comes Dracut. Well, it looks like they're huddling up a little bit. Okay. This is my second year doing these games, into my second year. And this is the first huddle I've seen from Dracut High School. Crowley brings him out. He's got trips right. Snap. Ball to number 2, Justin Gauthier. Gauthier had a nice 12-yard gain for a first down. I think Dracut found something inside. And they're back on the line. Crowley again in shotgun. Again, hand off to Gauthier, and Gauthier is cut down in the backfield. So now Dracut will be in a 2nd and 12. 11 or 12. Drake is in huddle getting signals from the coach. Listen, they might be trying to slow the game down a little bit. Go on a nice sustained drive, keep their defense off the field, and move the clock a little bit. Crowley in shotgun. Snaps to Crowley. Gauthier on the carry. And he's bottled up at his own 46-yard line. No gain. Be third and 12.
Run stopper, no loss. No gain.
So now we have a third down. Third and 13. And we'll see what Drake comes up with here. Crowley's in shotgun. Gauthier to his right. Crowley calling signal, snap. Looking downfield. Pass to number 25, complete, but no gain.
Crowley's pass complete to the right side to number 25. Kyle Maxson. Stop the line. Fourth down and 10. Number 25,
Kyle Macklin on the reception. No gain. Fourth down, Drake will be punting. Drake in an unusual spread punt formation. Low snap. Punts away. Good punt. Fielded by number 11, Nicholas Filorio. And tackled by Kyle Macklin again on the tackle.
Westford Academy will take over in their own zone.
Westford will take over on their own 13-yard line. This is the worst field position they've had the whole game. We'll see how they come out and what kind of strategy the Westford Academy coaches use in getting out of this hole they're in right now. Degenhart in pistol. Dual receivers to his right. Inside handoff to number 31. Ben Cassidy.
Runs to the left side for a first down.
Tackled by number 1, Zach Burgoyne. Snap again, inside handoff to Cassidy. Tackled by number 25.
Cassidy again to the left. Not for another first down.
Kyle Maxim. Westford first down at their own 35-yard line. They got out of that hole pretty quick. Dellenhart behind center, or actually in shotgun, looking downfield. The rush is on. He moves to his right. He avoids one tackler, goes downfield, spins, and gets on the ground on the 41-yard line with a gain of 7 yards. Nice job by the quarterback, Dellenhart. And Drake had three opportunities to bring him down and sack him. But he made a positive play. The coverage downfield was very good. So now Westford Academy is second and 5. Degenhart in pistol. Surveys the defense, call signals. Snap, inside handoff to Cassidy. Tackled by number 1,
Cassidy,
Zach Burgoyne. Looks like we're at a third down and about 1, maybe a half a yard. Dellenhart in shotgun snap, quarterback draw, first down up the field, down to the Drake at 45-yard line, tackled by number 2, Justin Gauthier.
Enough for a first down and over midfield for Westford Academy.
So Westford has a first down at their own 46-yard line. Degenhart again in pistol. Handoff inside to Cassidy, up the middle. For about a 14-yard gain to the Dracut 31-yard line. Again, Westford lines up quickly. Degenhart calling signals. Takes a snap, inside handoff to Cassidy again. Up the middle for a 4-yard gain. Tackled by number 50, Brandon Segal. Second and 6 for Westford. Degenhart calling signals. Surveys the defense. Snap rolls right. Open is number 81, Scotty Callahan. Scotty makes a nice run after catch, and he gets down to the Dracut 15-yard line. And we have a timeout, Westford Academy. With first and 10 from Dracut's 15-yard line. Well, we'll see if Dracut can come up with something here, ladies and gentlemen. Westford has been going up and down the field at will. And time for someone to step up and make a play here. Oh, we have our clock back. We have 5:51 left in the first half. Looks like we've got a good crowd shot going. Mikey Poitras is down there with the camera. Drop by and say hello. Degenhart over in pistol formation. Cassidy to his left. Dual receivers left. One split right. Snap, handoff inside to Cassidy, and he's taken down in the backfield. No, that's Degenhart. Well, he faked me out, so he got the Dracut defense too. That was a zone read. The whole Dracut defense played Cassidy, and Degenhart kept it himself and went into the end zone for a nice 15-yard run. That was a very good series by Westford Academy. They drove 85 yards for the score. Pilichowski, I think that's how you say it, is attempting the extra point. Snap, ball down, kick up. And the kick is good. Coming up field for the kickoff, the score is Westford Academy, Grey Ghost 21, and the Dracut High Middies 0. Oh, we got relief. Coach Golick is here and he's doing the clock. And I still have never forgiven him for never letting me pitch. Well, folks, Drake has got a little hole to dig out of. I think it's time to tackle and play some defense and maybe shorten the game a little bit. Pilichowski sets a kick back deep for Dracut. Ball is fumbled, picked up, coming up field, and he made a nice return out of that. Folks, I will tell you the young man's name, but at this time of night, it's very difficult to see the numbers, so we'll just get the kind of the action. If I can see a number, I'll give you the number. So we have 5 minutes and 38 seconds to go. Dracut can't make 21 points up on one drive, so they need to sustain a drive, get down the field, put it in the end zone, and then come out in the second half and play some defense. Number 12, Crowley, in shotgun. Surveys the defense, takes the snap, inside handoff to number two, Justin Gauthier. No gain on the play. Terrific inside defense on that play by the Westford Grey Ghosts. Well, actually, gain of a yard. I'm looking at the stick. So we have second and nine. Crowley in shotgun. Trips to the right to the short side of the field. Back to pass. Oh, picked off by number 11, Nicholas Ferrillo, in for the touchdown. That was a wonderful play by Fiorello. He read the whole thing, and when the quarterback threw the ball, he was already breaking to that spot. That's a wonderful anticipation. That's a very nice football play by that young man. Westford's lining up for the extra point. Number 16, Pilichowski, set to kick with number 15, Cathcart, as his holder. Pilichowski sets up. Snap, ball down, kick is up, and the kick is good. Coming up for the kickoff, the score is 28 for the Westford Academy Grey Ghosts and 0 for the Dracut High Middies. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is Dracut. You should keep the same mindset. They should try to possess the ball, have a good offensive drive. You can't make up 28 points on one drive. Have a good offensive drive, put it in the end zone, and then come out in the second half and keep playing. Just keep playing. This is development time. So back deep for Dracut is number 30, Zach Lackmanny. And number 8, Troy Zwicker. Pilichowski gives his orders, sets his line. And the kick is off. The ball comes down to number 30, Zach Manny, and he gets outside and he's coming up the right sidelines. And he was pushed out of bounds on a nice play by number 7, Kevin Enos. But a wonderful return for Zach Lackmanny. He saw a hole on the right side. There's some good blocking by Dracut High. And he saw it and turned the burners on and got to the outside and brought him into good field position. Maybe that's a spark Dracut needs to get going in this game. Now out comes the Dracut High offense. Crowley leads him out.
Dracut will take over first and 10 after the big return.
Number 31, Cho to his left. Crowley in shotgun snap, drops back the pass, fires down the middle, and it's incomplete. Almost picked off by number 6, Nick Lazine. So now we have a second down and 10 yards to go from Dracut from their own 49-yard line. That was a 52-yard return as Lachmany got the ball in the end zone, probably about 2 yards deep, read his blocks, and showed some definite speed getting out to the outside. Crowley brings him out. Calling signals. Inside handoff to number 31, Zach Lachmany. Lachmany. Excuse me, that's David Choate. Again, no gain, almost a loss of one on the play, so we'll have third down and 11. Drake it in a huddle. We have 4 minutes and 13 seconds left in the first half. Crowley in shotgun, calling all signals. Snap, back to pass. Looks downfield, looks to his right. Fires the ball. Complete to number 6. Michael Odina. And he breaks a tackle, and he goes all the way down to the Westford Academy 15-yard line. Drake is picking up a little momentum here. They need to sustain it and get some points on the board before halftime. Clock won't start until they set the chains up. So Crowley is in shotgun. With Choate to his right. Ball out to Choate. Over the left guard. A pickup of 4 yards down to the 11-yard line. And Drake starts building offensive momentum.
Gain of 4. Be second down.
Crowley comes out. Gets the play sent in from the bench, looks at his wristband, call signal, snap, looking to his right, throws a slant down the middle, and that is in for a touchdown. A wonderful throw on that slant pattern, looked away the safety, came back up across the middle.
Touchdown pass was caught by number 10, Michael Lavasser.
Michael Lavasser on the touchdown. Look, Drake is going for two here. Shotgun trips left. Crowley calling signals. Snap. Snaps on the ground. Westford recovers. And the point after is no good.
No good, bad snap.
So the score. With 2 minutes and 56 seconds left in the first half, Westford Academy Grey goes 28 and Dracut High Middies 6. That was a very important drive. That drive was all set up by the kickoff return of number 31 by number 30, Zach Lachmany. Set the kickoff for Dracut. Give me one moment, folks. I have to read the young man's number. But set the kickoff for Dracut. I wouldn't be surprised with an onside kick here. They've got a little momentum here. Ball is set. Kicker approaches the ball. Ball comes down to the 15-yard line. Taken by number 24, Eric Jacobson. Westford Academy has the ball with 2 minutes and 50 seconds left at their own 24-yard line.
Number
See if we can if we can get a defensive stand here by the Dracut Middies. Dylan Hart in shotgun, rolls to his left. Rolls to his left, looks downfield, fires, incomplete. Great coverage by number 18, Stephen Lopez, as Delahart was looking downfield for number 81, Scotty Callahan. Incomplete. Degenhart behind in a pistol. Snap, handoff inside for number 31. Ben Cassidy. Cassidy brings the ball out to about the 30-yard line. Gain of six, it'll be third down and four. Snap out to the right, complete for a first down to number 24, Eric Jacobson. And that's enough for a first down. Clock will start upon spotting of the ball, as the custom in high school and college football. .209, .208, .207 left in the first half. Degenhart behind center takes a snap, looks downfield, stands in the pocket, fires deep to number 11. Oh, and it's broken up. That play was broken up by number 9, Dimitri Vieira. And while Westford Academy has a second down and 10 from their own 35-yard line. Degenhart in pistol. Calls all signals. Gets a snap. Hand off to Cassidy. Cassidy is close to a first down, up to about the 45-yard line, maybe 45 and a half-yard line. The initial hit was by number 1, Zach Burgoyne. So now we have a third and one at the Westford Academy, 45-yard line. Degenhart in a pistol formation, Cassidy to his left. Dual receivers split left to his left. Snap, handoff to Cassidy. No, kept by Degenhart for a first down. Tackled in the open field. A nice tackle.
Handoff. Kept by the quarterback. Run enough for a first down. Just shy of midfield.
A nice 4-yard gain for a first down.
First and 10, Westford Academy.
Tackle by number 8, Troy Zwicker. Degenhart back to pass, looking downfield. Moves to his right, and he's actually sacked himself. His knees on the ground. Play ends. Could have hurt himself. I think they need time out to check the young man out, because he looked like he slipped on the grass in an awkward angle.
Timeout on the field.
So now it's second down and 15 for the Westford Academy Grey Ghosts. Now, if he's unable to continue, or he's not running as well as he did earlier, Dracut knows that, then Cassidy might be his number one running back and overall receiver. So Dracut can key on that. Well, it doesn't appear it's good. It doesn't appear the young man is hurt. He's walking a little gingerly, but he's looking at his spikes more than anything. Second and 15. Degenhart in shotgun. Cassidy to his right. Snap. Degenhout looks downfield, and he is sacked. Michael Lavassa come flying in there, and I'm not sure what kind of mobility the quarterback has now, but he didn't move out of there. And Lavassa made a great play, brought him to the ground, and Dracut has him third down, and it looks like, I would say, 22 yards to go. With a minute and 4 seconds left, in the first half, I would believe that I don't think Westford Academy made a chance to pass, especially with the quarterback not moving well. I'd be looking for Cassidy to run the ball. Well, there you go. I'm wrong. Rolls to the right, looking downfield, fires, out of bounds, and it's complete. But it's still fourth. Now it's fourth down and 11. Dracut has held. So we'll see if Westford's going to punt. I would believe they are. Well, they trust their defense, so maybe they're gonna have a quick kick or something. The clock is running with 30 seconds left, 29, 28. They could probably take the penalty, then punt it away. As Degenhardt isn't coming up to take the snap or is not even calling for the ball. So now a timeout with 12 seconds left. So this keeps the Dracut High offense off the field, but they still have an opportunity in the punt. So coming up at halftime will be the Dracut High band. Not sure what they're gonna be playing, but it's always entertaining. So please stay around after our break. We're going to have a short break, and then we'll be back to watch the band, and then we'll start with third quarter action. Back to punt is number 16, Pilichowski, who's their place kicker also. Westford is already in their punt formation. Back for Dracut will be number 4. Derek Terrio. Looks like there's a fumble in the play. Westford has the ball. They're pointing that way. With there's 2 seconds left in the quarter. And on a change of possession, the clock stops. It was definitely hit by the Dracut receiver. And there's a flag upfield, and it looks like it's either roughing the passer or running into the passer, the kicker. Well, they're going to come for a conference. And they're going to refuse, Westford's refusing the penalty. Either going to try to kick a field goal or they're going to go for the end zone. And my guess is that they're going to go for the end zone. Number 81, Scotty Callahan, is the guy they're going to be shooting for. They had him roughing the kicker. It would have been a first down. Down at the and the play wouldn't have ended on a penalty. The first half, I don't believe. Well, that was at a change of possession if the ball is kicked, and that would be an offensive penalty that maybe the half would have ended. But we were down to 2 seconds left, and we'll see what Worcester Academy does. I don't think they're bringing out the field goal team. And looks like we have a man-to-man on number 81 who split out to the left, Callahan. Degenhardt behind center. Back to pass. Throw to the end zone. Well, looks like we have an interference call on Dracut. And that will be not a spot foul. That'll be a 10-yard penalty or half the distance of the goal. And the half will have ended on that throw, except that the half cannot end on a defensive penalty. So Westford will have one more shot at the end zone. So Westford will have the ball as the officials try to figure it out. Westford will have the ball at the 5-yard line. And now they're going to be kicking a field goal. Pilowski is the kicker. Cathcart is the holder. As we know, in the rules, ladies and gentlemen, a half cannot end on a defensive penalty. So that's why Westford has this opportunity to score. And there's our man, Mike Poitras, giving you the field shots for tonight. And the field goal attempt is up and good. So the score at the end of the first half is Westford Academy 31 and the Dracut Middies 6.
Westford Academy 31.
And ladies and gentlemen, we will be back for the playing of the Dracut High Band after this break. Thank you. And introducing welcome to halftime and the Dracut High School Marching Band. What I'm going to do at this point is, while you enjoy the band, I'm going to read the names of our cheerleaders. Our cheerleaders are Nicole Cloutier, Devon Cormier, Kelsey Duggan, Michaela Schwartz, Noelle Beeland, Hannah Berthold, Victoria Broadbent, Haley Flynn, Hannah Patinode, Mackenzie Tower, Paige Anus, Haley Boulette, Mary Boulette, Madison Brum, Kylie Dowling, Alexis Gardner Cadillac, Haley Lucas, Jaden McLeod, Caroline Mercier, Sarah Mercier, Alexis Perry, Sarah Picard, and Faith Poitras. Now, enjoy the band. Thank you. me when they want me on. Wonderful performance. A wonderful performance by the Dracut High School band. We will be returning after a short break with the score. Westford Academy 31 and the Dracut High School Middies 6. And when we get back, we'll give a brief recap of the first half.
$107.
Well, welcome back to the beginning of the second half. Looking back at the first half, it was not a very good half for Dracut. I believe they got caught in a little bit of rut on defense. Westford Academy really played very well on both sides of the ball. But they hung in there. They have to play tough. And I think what the coaches are going to try to do in the second half is to find out who wants to play. And they're going to find out about their team, because you find more, and this may sound corny, folks, but you find more in adversity than you do if everything's going well. So we'll see who wants to play and who doesn't. And, you know, if any of you have seen the NFL Network's thing on the Patriots this past week, Belichick found out more about his team than in losing and getting really whacked at Kansas City than he did, winning games against Oakland and whatever they played to open up the season. So this is a good opportunity for the Dracut High coaches to be able to study some film, find out who can play, and don't worry about the scoreboard in the second half. Actually, try to play well. Just try to play well. Now, I think we have a little bit of a lighting situation here where some of the banks of lights are out and the scoreboard is out. You know, somebody joked up here, they're wondering if Bill Belichick is around or the Patriots around to do anything to help Dracut High here. So let's see how this goes. Dracut High is already lined up for the second half kickoff. Actually, they're lined up on the wrong side. Westford Academy will be kicking from on your TV screen from your left to the right. And Dracut High is receiving in the second half. So it would be nice if they could push one in, get some points, and see where they go from here. Again, it's a little dark here at Beaudry Field. Some of the lights went out, and I think they're endeavoring to try to get them back on. You know, if the kids have some fun. It's like playing in the dark. Have some fun. Nice time for ball deception. Some play-action passes, some zone reads, since the lights aren't that bright. Time to take advantage of it on the offense. So ready to kick is Pilichowski for Westford Academy. He approaches the ball, kicks it down to the right corner. Taken by the Dracut High, ready, looking upfield. There was a hole there, he's trying to get the corner. And he's taken out of bounds at the, as I can see where the referee is starting, at the 22-yard line. Westford kicked it all the way to the left-hand corner. Dracut had their return set up on the right-hand side. And now Dracut goes on offense.
22-23. Dracut will take over. First and 10 from their own 23.
Again, we're going to have to rely on the referees for time management here. So what we have is we have Crowley and shotgun. Calling signals, looking over the defense. Ball is snapped, handoff inside. And a gain of about 2.5-3 yards. Carry by number 31, David Choate. Sorry for the delay, ladies and gentlemen, but the Dracut High numbers are kind of blending into their jersey, so there may be a little delay in finding out who is who. Crowley behind again in shotgun, inside handoff to Choate. He has an opening, and he brings the ball out to the 31-yard line, 36-yard line, And it looks like a Draken High first down. Very nice as Draken pushed the ball out from deep in their territory with a first down and two plays. And that's what they need. They need to make do this drive like the score is 0-0. Crowley again in shotgun. Cho to his right. Snap to Crowley. Give us to Cho. Cho is wrestled down by number 63. Oliver Fortnier LeMay.
Handoff for a short game.
Gain of two, second down and eight. Well, at least the down works. Again, Drake it is out over center. Crowley in shotgun. Choate with the carry, avoids one tackler, and is taken down after a 9-yard gain by number 24, Eric Jacobson. Drake is starting to get something going here, and he does get a first down. So this is the second first down in a row on the ground by Drake. They're starting to pick up a little momentum here. Crowley in shotgun, hands to Choate, and he's stacked up by number 78, Jacob Gomez, big D lineman. And that's a loss of two. So now we have a second and 12. With the ball at the Dracut 46-yard line. The only thing working on our scoreboard is the down, so at least we'll be accurate there. Plays getting sent in from the sidelines. All the Dracut players look at their wristbands. Crowley in shotgun. Give is the Choate. That's Burgoyne. No, that's not Burgoyne. That is Justin Gauthier. And now we have third and eight. I think Drake is in two down territory here. Design a play 5, 6, 7 yards. Don't force it down the field and then have a relatively short fourth down play. So let's see where the Drake and High coaches are thinking. See if they're thinking along with me here. And the throw is to the right. It is complete for a 7-yard gain. Coming back. Michael Lavassa coming back for the ball. Made a beautiful catch. Now we have fourth and four. We're in a manageable fourth down situation here. We can run. We'll run the zone read. He can throw the bubble screen. He can throw the slant down the field. All sorts of options with a short down and distance. So Crowley's out. Gauthier to his right. Twins right. Back to pass. Down the middle. He's open. Oh, and is incomplete. Crowley did the best he could as he was being hit by the defensive line of the Westford Gregos. And his pass was incomplete to number 6, Michael O'Donnell. And we have a coaching moment here for Drake. As when O'Donnell came off the field, the coach was motioning him to come back to the ball. But that's all with experience. Remember, a lot of these players for Dracut High School were on the JV team last year, and they're getting their first taste of varsity ball tonight. And they have a relatively young team starting a lot of sophomores and juniors. So, as I believe the quarterback, Crowley, is a junior. Under center. Hand off to Cassidy. Cuts it upfield for a first down. And is tackled. By number 18, Stephen Lopez. Stephen's playing defensive secondary, so by the time he got the tackle, a first down was made. So, Degenhart in shotgun. Twins left, Callahan right, back to pass, looks right, fires like almost like a naked, like a little bit of a skinny slant. Caught by number 24, Eric Jacobson. So now we have a second and short, second and 2.5, second and 2. Dellinghart, snap, looks to his right, and complete to number 11, Nicholas Fiorello. And that should be enough for a first down. So Westford has a first down at the Dracut 30-yard line. We're in the third quarter, though we don't know how much time is left. I'm probably guessing that we may have 6 minutes left in the quarter. Degenhart, in shotgun. Hands to Cassidy, up the middle, cuts. Gives a dead leg and just gets a nice 9-yard gain.
Hand off, number 31, Cassidy.
Cassidy for the nice 9-yard gain. We have a second and short. This is a great way to play offense, folks. When you can play second and short, now you can take your shots downfield and can get you, if it doesn't work, get your first downs. Degenhart in shotgun, snap. Hand it to Cassidy. Cassidy's up the middle, down to the Dracut 12-yard line for a first down. And then we don't have a operating clock right now, so we're in the third quarter sometime, probably halfway through. Degenhart in shotgun, snap, ball's on the ground, and his knee is down, and now it counts as a sack.
Ball snap. Degenhart is down in the backfield. Bring up second,
about 16. That helped. Drake, big loss from the play, second and 16, Degenhart. In shotgun, twins to his right, tight end to his right. It's actually quads because he's got four guys over there he can use. Looks to his right, fires across the middle, and that pass is incomplete. Attempted for number 11, Nicholas Fiorello, covered by number 6, Michael O'Donna. Third and long for Westford. Degenhart in shotgun.
Whistle before the snap.
Yeah, there was some movement. Looks like number 31 was moving quick because he saw they changed the protection. He saw that the Dracut High was coming on a blitz and wanted to get over there early to pick him up to protect his quarterback. So now we have a 5-yard penalty. It's now third down and about 20 to 21 yards at the Dracut 21-yard line. Westford has already kicked a field goal tonight, and my guess is they will try to get about half of this back and kick another one with a commanding 31-6 lead with not so sure how much time is left on the clock in the half, in the quarter. Degenhart behind center and shotgun. Now we have another whistle on another flag. Another legal procedure. It looked like the left guard for Westford Academy moved. So now it's going to be a fourth down, and we have my math, 26 yards. So I don't know what play you have in your bag for fourth and 26, but we'll soon see. Degenhart is in shotgun behind center. Cassidy to his left. He just might hand it off on his own read. Oh, he goes back to pass, looks to his right, fires short, and ball is incomplete. Looks like number 24, Eric Jacobson, was looking to run before he caught the ball. So now we have a fourth down and 26. So this is where we may see like a throw to the end zone pass here for Westford Academy. I think they're too far out for a field goal. But if they do punt it, and they punt it into the end zone, Drake comes out to the 20. Although they're only on the 26, they might as well take a shot. They have Callahan, who would be my target, out to the left. And that's who he's looking at. Nope, throws the ball down the middle, and it's intercepted. Intercepted by number 6, Michael O'Donna.
intercepted by number 6, Michael Odiana.
Odiana. And that was a nice play. Well, it was almost like a punt. So, I mean, he made a nice play. He read the quarterback. Quarterback tried to force the ball in the middle of the field. And by playing safety, he got a read on that ball all the way. So we have a first and 10 for Dracut at their own 24-yard line. They've held. And now I'm not so sure much, again, how much time. I would like to tell you the time left in the third quarter. Maybe we can get somebody to ask the officials down on the field. Crowley's in shotgun. Short gain. Sorry, folks, I'd like to tell you who that was, but I can't read his number from here. So it could be number 31, David Choate. I'll give it to David. So we got second down and 9 after a 1-yard gain. Crowley again in shotgun. Hands the ball off to Crowley again. Picks his way through and gets a 3-yard gain out to the 30-yard line. So Drake will have a third down and 5. Crowley in shotgun, trips to the right. Snap. Zone read. Crowley keeps. Cuts it up, and he may have enough for the first down. I'm not sure. Looks like the spot coming in is right in the line, and it may be enough for a first down. We may have a measurement here. That was a nice play because he's been handing the ball off the choke, and he made it by the nose. Looks like they didn't measure it, but it looks like he had to get across that line, and he did by a couple inches. So now we have a first and 10 from the 35. Drake, another first down. Inside hand off the choke, and he gets wrapped up by the center of the Worcester Academy defense. And now we have a second down and 8 from the Dracut 38-yard line. Dracut in the huddle, quarterback getting the play, and then I think this is smart. Make sure everybody's on the same page. It just you're looking down the line, and there's a timeout in the field. No, I need that. Ooh, excuse me. Excuse me, folks. Somebody's taking pictures of my rosters here, and it looks like they're going to walk away with them, which would leave me more helpless than I am now. So we have a second down and 8 from the Dracut 37-yard line, and again, Dracut coaches are on the field talking to the official. Crowley's in shotgun. We got trips to the left. Single receiver out right. Crowley looking over the defense, calling signals. Snap, fake handoff, down the middle, intercepted. Intercepted by number 21, Nick Diamond. Diamond is going to the right corner, and he goes in. No, he's out. He's out of bounds at the 1-yard line. Boy, that was a nice play by Diamond. He went into his hook zone as a linebacker, read the quarterback's eyes, and reacted to the ball.
Sorry, oh, Paula Chaucy, the George. George still
Westford Academy has the ball on the first and goal from their one. Degenhardt takes a snap, hands the ball to Cassidy, and he gets down to the 1 yard line.
Off for a short game.
What was that diamond? Well, I think we have a second down and one. Timeout on the official. Worcester Academy defense has been very active tonight. That was a wonderful interception. As he kind of lurking in the weeds, read the quarterback's eyes, broke with the ball, and then he had the speed to get down the field and almost get it into the end zone. The Dracut High Athletic Director is in the booth, and we're trying to work on these electrical issues we have up here. Is Bill Belichick here? Is this the problem we're having? Is Belichick here, Gil? I think so. Because that's why nothing's working, right? But it should be for Dracut's advantage. It shouldn't be. Oh, those dirty tricks. Is somebody? It looks like somebody is injured, right? I couldn't see that as it was in front. His whole team was kneeling in front of him, and he's walking off the field, and that's good news. And I'll let you know who he is as soon as I can see the back of his jersey. Mike Poitras getting some great shots down on the. Looks like we're off the air.
I'll be a play-by-play guy.
It looks like we're back on there. We're having all sorts of electrical issues up here, and we're still in timeout. And we have our new athletic director trying to figure out the panel here. They don't want me near it because I'll blow a fuse. There's no question about that. Well, here comes Westford Academy back. Dracut will join them in a moment. I'm trying to find out if there's any word in any time in the third quarter. Degenhardt under center. 11 comes in motion. Ferrello hand to number 21. And he's kept out. Number 21, Joey Diamond. It looks like the coaches of Westford are trying to reward him after he made that wonderful interception. Oh, that is, and that is, now we know what the time of the third quarter is. The third quarter is over.
Your score after three, Westford Academy 31.
Westford Academy 31, Dracut 6. And that was a good quarter for Dracut High School. Westford didn't score, they didn't drive the field, and Dracut had some sustained offense. So there's some positive signs there for the coaches to work with. Okay, we're going to be starting the fourth quarter at Westford with third and goal from the Dracut 1 yard line.
Yeah.
Westford Academy.
Degenhart behind center. In shotgun. Motion. Motion back. Handoff. And it looks like he stopped at the 1 yard. Oh no, he's in for the touchdown. The side judge came in and gave us a signal. Well, that was a good goal line stand for Dracut. They went all the way to third down before they put it in the end zone. Remember, they started this drive at Dracut's 1 yard line, folks. Dracut gave him a hard time getting the ball in. I think the kids are starting to grow. So we'll see how the fourth quarter goes for these guys and see what, you know, they look like they're in good shape. I know the coaches have been working them hard. And let's see how disciplined they are and keep playing. Just keep playing. Oh, we have a football thrown out of the game. We're going to check the pressure on that football. Hope it wasn't deflated. Pilichowski for the extra point. The kick is up, and the kick is good.
And so the score
with...
Early
in the fourth quarter is Westford Academy 38 and Dracut High Middies 6.
At this time, I'd like to recognize from the Dracut sideline, a returning Grand National champion, cheerleaders.
Well, folks, Dracut Access Cable will be carrying the home games for the Dracut High Middies on local cable. Just look for the times and check it out. And also, we'll be here to end the season against Methuen, hosting the annual Dracut High Methuen Thanksgiving Day game, which is down the road in November. We realize we're September 11th, but Thanksgiving comes quick. Westford kicking off to Dracut. Pilichowski to kick off. Oh, the ball fell off the tee. Chelsky approaches the ball, kicks it. Ball is shallow. Actually down to the 4 yard line. Pretty good kick. Another nice return for Zach Lackmany. That's a second nice return. They had a return set up right, similar to the other one. And he got the ball past the 30 yard line to the 32 yard line.
Take over in the fourth quarter.
So let's see Dracut's offense. They've had some momentum in this half. Just need a nice, long, sustained drive. Put it in the end zone. Feel good about yourselves. And here comes the Dracut High offense with Crowley and Choate in the backfield. Crowley a quarterback in shotgun. Twin receivers left. Hand off the choke, cuts it up inside, fights his way, and gets it in a 3 yard gain.
So
it'll be second down.
It'll
be second down and 7 from the Dracut 36 yard line. Dracut looking in for their plays. Crowley in shotgun. David showed to his left. Probably run the zone read, at least the zone read look. Yep, hand off to Choate over left guard. Gets the ball out to the 40-yard line and makes it a very manageable third and 3. I think Dracut's looking to sustain something, folks. They need to build something here, and it looks like the offense has played much better in the second half, and as has the defense, which shows the kids are working hard and they're in shape. Crowley in shotgun. Hands the ball to Choate off the left guard. gets stacked up in the middle of the field. It looks like he has enough for the first down, though.
Run by Joe for a short game.
I'm looking at the official running in and spotting the ball. It looks like he has enough for the first down. And he does. Dracut comes out again in shotgun. We will say that all night, as Dracut typically does not take snaps in the center. We have Crowley in shotgun, I believe Choate to his left. And we have Trips receive his left. Kyle Maxim to his right. And off the Choate, and he's met by half the Westford defense. Led by number 12, Tyler Blagg. So now we have basically a no gain, second and 10 from the Dracut 45. Crowley again in shotgun. Choate to his left. Twin receivers right, hand off to Choate over right tackle. Cuts it up inside, spins, gets a first down, and carries two Westford Academy tacklers over. Over the 45-yard line, and now it settles for a first down at the 42. First down, Dracut High School. And folks, this has all been done on the ground. Dracut started at their own 32, and now they've driven to the Westford Academy 42. Crowley, shotgun snap, looking downfield, whistle blows.
Whistle at the snap, flag on the play.
Looks like when they deaden the play, it's a... Yeah, legal procedure. So now it'll be a first and 15 for Dracut High School. From their own 46-yard line. 47.
Looks like we had a false start. Little back to Middies up 5 yards. It'll be first and 15.
Dracut's all getting their plays. You see them look at their wristbands. Crowley and shotgun. Choate to his left, hand off to Choate, cuts, and is stacked up, led by the Westford High defense, led by number 53, Max Silverman, playing inside linebacker. A short gain, so now we have a second down and 12 and a half yards to go from the Dracut 45. Dracut come out with quads right. When I say quads, that means four receivers to quads left. That means there's four receivers on that side. There's a tight end, there's a slot. The tight end just spread out there, and you have your running back to the left of the quarterback. That means four eligible receivers on that side. That's what I mean by quads. Crowley running to his right, is being chased, and gets out of bounds, and that's a flag.
Is it?
Now we'll have a Dracut first down. We have a personal foul on number 36, Ben Antes, and it looks like Ben got a little aggressive in that spot and hit him while he was going out of bounds. And so now we have an automatic first down for Dracut High School. The ball comes down to the 28-yard line of the Westford Academy Grey Ghosts. Crowley's looking in for the play from the bench. In shotgun, Choate to his right. Hand off of Choate over right guard. Spins and now gets taken down by number 55. We don't have a number 55, folks. So number 55 of Westford Academy. I don't have his name on this roster. And now we have a second down and 8, short gain of 2. Coming into the game at running back is number 1, Zach Burgoyne. And he's to Crowley's right. Twins left. Snap down. Hands off to Burgoyne.
For maybe a
loss of 2. So we're going to have a third down and 10. Critical play for Dracut here to keep this drive going. Again, they're in 2 down territory. So a nice 5-6 yard gain here. They can come back and can use all the plays in their arsenal. If they don't get a gain here and they go for it, then it's probably a pass play. So Westford could play for that. They've been swarming in the defensive backfield tonight. Crowley takes a snap, looks downfield, fires for the corner, and that is complete for a touchdown for the Great and High Mini. Wonderful throw by Burgoyne. He threw it on the break. Before the defense could set, he threw it on the break before the receiver broke. The receiver caught it in stride, brought it into the end zone, and now Dracut went on a 70-yard scoring drive. And now Dracut setting up for the two-point conversion. Dracut has 12 points now, and Westford Academy is 38-12. Dracut going for two. Snap to Crowley, looking downfield. Goes to his right. Fires to the end zone, incomplete. Nice effort. So the score as they come up field is the Westford Grey Ghosts 38, the Dracut High Middies 12. Dracut's played very well in the second half. They matched Westford. Although Westford may have lost a little intensity, Dracut has kept playing. That's a great sign. You know, some positive.
After the touchdown, score is now Westford Academy 38.
Some positive aspects of this game from this Dracut team seems to be a disciplined team. They're not taking a lot of penalties. They're not making mistakes in the fourth quarter. They're just playing hard. I think Coach Rivers likes this group of kids. And they'll grow from this game, and they'll understand what they can do, what they can't do, and they'll get better, because they got better throughout this game. Dracut High kicking off. Ball is down at the 40. Ball is kicked. Number 11, Nick Ferrillo, and he gets tackled at the 27-yard line. Good coverage. They gotta just keep playing. That touchdown, by the way, folks, was by Stephen Pelletier, a senior, wide receiver, cornerback. Very nice play, great throw. Caught the ball in stride, ran it in, nice job. Westford Academy over the ball. Number 41 in the backfield is Tyler Silton. Hands to Tyler. And he gets a 5-yard gain. In the game, the quarterback for Westford Academy is number 15, Andrew Cathcart. Andrew is the holder on extra points and the backup quarterback. Westford Academy is starting to play its younger kids. Although Cathcart is a junior. Cathcart in shotgun. Silton to his left. Silton gets the ball over right tackle. And he's swarmed by a pack of Dracut High defenders, but he has enough for the first down. So now we have a first and 10 for Westford Academy at their own 41-yard line. Cathcart in shotgun. Silton to his left. Silton has the ball over right guard. And he's brought down by, again, the Dracut defensive line. And so we'll have a second and seven. Second and six. Westford has a second down and six at their own 45-yard line. Cathcart in pistol. And when I say pistol, it's not as deep as shotgun with a back behind him. So we call that pistol. Cathcart on the carry. Silton on the carry. No gain, and now it'll be third and six. As Dracut High starts putting in its reserves right now its younger players, and these are opportunities you have to have your younger players on film so you can evaluate them. And that's what the Dracut High coaches are doing now. Plus, everybody in certain situations should play because, you know, you all work hard in practice. You all run your sprints. You all go to the weight room. So if there's an opportunity for everybody to play, the coaches usually like to get everybody in the game.
And that whistle signals the two-minute warning.
And there's two minutes left in the fourth quarter. The officials were kind enough to tell us it was 2 minutes left in the game with the score. Westford Academy 38, Dracut High School 12. Cathcart and shotgun. Hands to number 41, Selton. And he is stuffed by the Dracut High School defensive line. A nice tackle by get his number, by number 76.
Tackle led by number 76, Brandon Left.
Number 76, Brendan Ouellette. Westford Academy is punting here. And that is Pilichowski. Gets the ball off. It comes up short. And it's fumbled by number 16, Jonathan Drossos. Westford Academy recovers it at the Dracut High 25-yard line. So now it's Westford's ball on Drake's 26-yard line.
And a timeout called by Drake.
Timeout by Drake. Probably, I'm thinking there may be like a minute and a half left in this game since the clock isn't working and, you know, both teams have their second units in and they've emptied the bench a little bit. And we still have Cathcart at quarterback and Selton at running back, and Cathcart's in the pistol formation with Cathcart to his right. Snap. Fake. Throw to the right. And that is incomplete. We have our athletic director standing next to me trying to fix the problems that Bill Belichick caused here in Dracut. I think Bill tried to give Dracut High an advantage here tonight. We're not so sure. They let me talk all night, I'll get silly like this. Cathcart is over center. Actually, he's in pistol with Selton to his right. Snap, handoff inside of Selton. And he's taken down by the inside of the Dracut defense. Looks like down to the 20-yard line. There'll be third down and four.
Circuit breaker off, that'll shut down.
It's going to be about third and four now for Westford Academy.
So here we go, and now we have a third and four as Westford puts more players in the game. As we're still trying to fix the electrical issues here at Dracut High School. We'll get them. We have till November. It's okay. Cathcart in pistol. Selton to his right. Twin slots to his right. Calling the play. Snap. And put a knee down. And I believe, folks, we should count this down, and that really should do it. As Westford Academy, and that's the end of the game with Westford Academy 38 and Dracut 12. We want to thank everybody for watching tonight's game, and look for the announcements for the next game that will be televised over Dracut Access cable to the town. So enjoy your evening, enjoy your weekend. I hope to see everybody out here at Old Home Day tomorrow. Thank you all and goodbye.
October 2nd, when your Middies take on North Andover.